All right, Mrs. Belfield, I'll take over. Bit of a come down, isn't it? Ah, still, I suppose it's better than being in the laundry with your mates.
Is this your idea of protection?
Get in the cell.
What for?
Because I said so. So you don't like the protection we're providing? Well, that's okay, because here's a little surprise. I'm taking your protection away. I'm telling all of the officers to stay clear.
But you can't do that. They're trying to kill me.
Oh, I don't think they're trying too hard. You're still alive. And I don't think you're that scared. Otherwise, you wouldn't still be telling us lies.
What lies?
You told us that Winter and Edwards planned the escape together.
That's true.
That is rubbish. They hated each other. They wouldn't work together. Winter reckons you killed Edwards.
She'd have to say that, wouldn't she? Say anything to save her neck.
So would you. Anything but the truth.
Look, I couldn't tell you the truth, could I? Not without implicating an officer.
Oh, what's that supposed to be?
I don't know whether Mari was involved, but I do know who sent Sandy to the rubbish area so she could get away. And I also know who she was having an affair with.
Who?
Steve Faulkner.
Long coffee break, Mr. Faulkner.
Sorry, I was just going.
No, not yet. I want a word with you. I've been following up your information on Winter and Peterson. It appears there's something they agree on after all.
Oh, good. What's the story?
You and Edwards were having an affair.
Edwards? Well, that's ridiculous. What are they saying, that they saw us at it?
No. Edwards openly boasted about it.
Well, so what? Those women are locked up without blokes for years. They're bound to fantasize to make up stories. You're not going to believe it, are you?
You've been taking a lot of interest in her escape.
Well, precisely. Why would I be asking questions if I knew where she was?
It could be a cover-up to put people off.
Yeah, and it could be a pack of lies. There's no proof.
No. At least not until we find Edwards. We will find her, sooner or later. And if I find out you've been abusing your position, I'll have you thrown out of the department so fast you won't know what hit you. That is, if the police don't arrest you first for aiding an escapee. It's not very pleasant to be an ex-screw in prison.
Have you seen Peterson?
No, she's been making herself real scarce. What are you going to do about her?
Just want to have a little talk to her first. I reckon she bumped off Edwards.
Whether she did or not, she's still a lagger. She ruined the kitchen lurk and the drugs, and she's got away with it.
Yeah. That's what she thinks.
Well, look, anything you want to do to her, you can count me in, as long as it's permanent.
Yeah. What's going on here? Didn't you hear the bell?
Oh, we were just wondering where Peterson was.
She's not hungry. She's staying in a cell, so come on, move.
That's all. You're good at getting information, aren't you? Like the stick you've been feeding the cops these past 3 months.
Ah, I don't know what you're talking about.
You gave my letter to Fitzwater to the cops, didn't you?
They set me up. They said they found a witness to get me off the murder charge. It was just another policeman. They tricked me.
What'd you expect? That's what they do to all those grasses. And you were a grass, weren't you? I'll give you one more chance to tell me what you did with Edwards.
I didn't do anything to her. She set you up. She said if I helped her get away, she wouldn't hurt me. It was a setup. She fooled you. It was all Sandy's idea. I didn't want to trick you. She was going to kill me.
Oh, you didn't have much choice then, did you?
No.
Either she killed you then or I kill you now.
Noticed you didn't have any lunch, Winter.
I wasn't hungry, Mrs. Powell.
I'll go and eat something anyhow. Keep your strength up.
I'll see you later, Tears.
You two work on the Sabo?
Yeah, clan.
Well, I'm gonna need some help with Peterson.
I thought you left the dining room to take care of that.
Yeah, well, I would have, wouldn't I? But Officer Powell came past. It's the second time I've been round to where Sil and the screws have come by. You're keeping a real close watch on her.
So what can we do?
Well, Powell's put her on kitchen duty. Now, her first job's gonna be to get the dirty plates from Solitary. Just make sure you're cleaning at the bottom of the stairs.
And then what?
Stop her coming back down again. I'll take care of the rest.
I thought you were working in the laundry.
I said I'd take care of it.
Okay.
She'll need more than luck. That's why I'm having a bit of a whip around. Would you like to give something?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, ta.
And don't take all day collecting the dirty dishes. Well, aren't you coming with me? I have work to do. Well, how do I get into Solitary then? Miss Conway's on duty up there. She'll let you through. Go on.
Come on, Peterson. You're as slow as a wet week.
Well, come on.
I can't, Miss Conway. They're waiting for me.
Who?
Lil and Margot. They were there when I came up.
Of course they are. They're on cleaning duty, as I remember.
But they'll still be there.
We can't lock everybody up just because you'd like the corridors to yourself, Peterson. Now get moving. Oh,
please, Miss Conway.
Move!
What are you waiting for?
What do you want? Why don't you come and find out?
Away with this.
What's the matter, Peterson? Lost your screw mates, have you?
You said you'd handle things from here, Murray. Let's go.
I've seen that knife before. Edward's got it off me. And there's only one way you